Celius back to the Astral Academy, life went on by as quietly as one can expect in the kingdom. The three heroes went about their lives, while back at the Astral Academy, students labored hard to impress their teachers. One student in particular was under scrutiny. Cornelius Cranstead was yet again trying to keep up with the demands of his professor.
Go to the Astral Archives and find a copy of the Esoteric Encyclopedia for the next lesson.
I'd be happy to, Professor Button. If you could have only told us where the library archives are. Probably search every nook and cranny and hope for the best. What's this? A music box. I wonder if it still works.
Please, just 5 more minutes, Margaret.
Wake up, wizard. It's time for action.
Is that a doggy I hear? Don't worry, little pup. Help is on the way.
It was night time in the kingdom, and the heroes of Trine were deep in sleep. Sinister powers had been at work, however, and they ended up sharing a common dream.
Thank you.
seemed a rather familiar little dog wanted once again for the heroes to give chase to him. And if Toby was present in the hero's dream, then Celius was sure to be nearby as well.
This mutt again.
Can you hear me?
Princess, you're not tampering with dream magics, are you?
I had to reach you somehow. There has been a magical accident at the Astral Academy. We need your help. Follow the dog and you'll find us.
I awoke to the pain of a new existence, in a dank womb of darkness and decay.
nightmares aren't on the loose again, are they, Celius?
Actually, it's a dream curse we're dealing with. Not one cast by me. The other students were in the Great Hall rehearsing a play for the Autumn Review. Something went wrong and everyone was sent into a magical slumber. We're trapped here.
Celius, are you the only one immune to the curse?
No. I'm with a student who remains unaffected.
Owl salutes heroes. Owl is a machine, so no dreams for Owl. Owl hopes the Trine heroes find the culprit. Maybe it's a dragon. A huge, sleeping, gas-breathing dragon.
Let's hope it's not.
the heroes of Tri. Care to try and solve this puzzle? Unsurprisingly, my students couldn't figure it out. How would you go about it?
Sorry about that. My last lesson with Butternut didn't go very well.
A little heads up would have been nice.
Thank you.
do love coming back to the Astral Academy time and time again. It is, after all, where our grand tale started in the first place.
The caster of the curse is hiding in one of the students' dreams. My portal will lead you there. You shouldn't be in danger because you three aren't actually here.
I see. We are sleepwalking.
Sleepwalking or not, let's save these little wizards and arrest the cursorer!
Ugh, looks like I can't evade the heroics even in dreams.
Our brave heroes of Trine found themselves in a peculiar situation, being invited by Celius into a stranger's dream. The dreamer was Ghislan of Alcyon, an exchange student at the Astral Academy. Ghislan's dream did not resemble anything like the Academy or her mystical home island on Alcyon. Her imagination had transported her to a brightly colored world of adventure and, surprisingly, fun.
I can't believe I skipped the spell potion exams for a treasure hunt.
Ah, what's one flunk test compared to the adventure of your life, lass?
So, this dream belongs to one of the Academy students.
I think I might like her. Pirate treasure hunt, I could go for that.
That's nice of young Celius, trying to help his friends by calling for us.
I'd rather have us solving this mystery than him and his murderous shadow.
sounds of battle. Oh no, it's Captain Silverpond and her crew coming to steal our treasure.
They can try. I'll fend off any ruffians with my spells.
No, we're not nasty pirates.
We're here to help. You're in a dangerous dream.
Rats! She can't hear us. We need to get closer.
Islan's magical talents were herbalism and healing. For a treasure hunt to be the subject of her dream, perhaps might have at first seemed out of place. So perhaps there was more to this little witch than met the eye.
need to leave this dream. I didn't invite you here, and you have definitely overstayed your welcome.
So, you're the one whispering in Ghislaine's ear. Who are you?
Somebody who will not look kindly upon intruders.
I should go. They're expecting me to return home soon.
The obedient Gislan, doing their bidding day after day, slowly turning bitter as she chokes on her duties. Or you could stay here with me. There's nothing wrong with being a little selfish sometimes.
this dream seems different from the nightmares we encountered when chasing Prince Celius.
Perhaps we're not dealing with nightmares, but happy dreams.
So, too much daydreaming is dangerous?
Gislan of Alcyon, I presume.
And you're Captain Silverpawn, no?
I wish.
Miss, you were cursed during your play rehearsals. This is a dream.
We're here to get you back to the Astral Academy.
I'm not going anywhere. Wait, what's happening?
The dream is collapsing.
Of Alcyon.
Gislan may have awakened, but the dream curse still kept its grip on the Academy. Hunting for the sinister spirit that kept its hold on the remaining students, the heroes were sent into another dream. Next, they were to discover the hopes and aspirations of one Caribel the Glacial.